going live.
Yeah, so it looks like the game... All right, so it looks like the game is going live. It's going to be the first semi-finals here at the ESL Benelux Championship at the Amsterdam Arena. It's going to be Lowland Lions versus Asterion. And Jere and Rick, take it away.
Thank you very much, Ward. As we are about to start with the ninth round, Lowland Lions versus Asterion indeed, and the shanking has commenced. Looks like it's going to be in favor of no one at the moment. It's 1-1.
It's 1-1. They're actually on... I believe it's Kaisking, who actually has 3 knife kills already. But he's on the same HP as Lewis Raver. And look at this standoff, man. The shanking part, as you like to call it. Who will come out on top? And it's Lewis Raver who will pick up that that knife round. So that means that Asterion is going to pick up that probable T side. So yeah. Rick, your prediction coming into this now that it is actually Lewis Raver picking up that knife round, so Asterion having the upper hand, at least in the first round.
Yeah, but choosing CT.
They're choosing CT. It is, to be fair, Dust2 is one of the more balanced maps, so you see a lot of teams. There's not really, like, a favorable side in this.
But is it that they just want to get this defense out of the way? Because, you know, the T side, you can pretty much dictate the pace of the game, and... Look at this, Asterion now in mid with 2 players. We've seen them doing, we've seen teams doing this before, and now Fasher picking up the first kill. Crucial will reply though, slaying down. Fasher with finding some another one. Fasher with the third frag of the round. Crucial down and out. And now only 2 players survive for Lowland Lions in a 2-on-4. And it's going to be a very difficult situation here for Lowland Lions. Kais King and Maul.
Are they going to go? Looks like they're actually going to go up short. Kinzo will make short work of Kaisking here. Fasher picks up his 4th. Fasher absolutely destroying the Lowland Lions there in the first pistol round, picking up 4, Rick. Insane play by him.
Wow. That's the confidence that we were talking about. Asterion delivering at this very first round at the ESL Benelux Championship. And now we can see they're actually not messing about there. Slain is the only man having an SMG. And... this is the mistake that Lowland Lions often make. They tend to go aggressive against these anti-eco rounds.
The problem is, to be fair, with a map like Dust2, you have a lot of long-range battles. So you really want to go for those FAMASes. Who's Ravo picking up a headshot there onto Maul through the door, I believe that even was. Nice little shot there from Lewis Ravo. But yeah, like I said, the long-range guns really been favored on the map like Dust2. So there are a lot of long-range battles. In the meantime, 4-on-3 situation. It is Kaisking actually also on low HP. Only has a Deagle to work with. Let's see where Kaisking is over towards middle. Maybe trying to pick up a cheeky one Deagle here. Not going to spot anyone. Looks like the bomb is actually going towards the catwalk area. And that means that it will be an A push with that bomb. Kaisking has a flashbang to work with. He's going to toss that over the wall. And that now means that the push is on towards A. It is looking very good right now for Lowland Lions. As Aaron picks up a Tech 9 frag down on Thymos. Kinzo replies quickly though with the revenge frag. Now 3-on-2. Bomb has been planted, so though this is a very good situation here for the Lowland Lions. You always want to get that bomb down, especially in a round like this, and that is exactly what happened. And Kaisking will get taken down from Fasher. And now it's all on the hands of Mono. Oh, he has a Deagle to work with. Can't land a shot there onto Slain. And that is the second round on the board here for Asterion CSGO. Only dropping 2 players, only having to force 2 revives. And it looks like we will actually be going into a pause. A technical pause, that is.
I can assume that, indeed. I mean, at least Lowland Lions got the bomb now. And they got 2 kills with it as well. So it's not that bad after all for the Lowland Lions team.
I'm not sure what's going on right now. The survey is now paused. Okay. So, yeah, Rick, first 2 rounds go to Asterion.
All right, so... all right, so we're taking it over at the desk a little bit. There's a technical pause going on. We saw the first 2 rounds here, and what can we tell from the first 2 rounds?
Well, I think the first round, Fasher just wiped Lowland Lions off the map. That's pretty much it. And the interesting fact as well, the 2 players from Asterion rushed straight through mid, which gave them a lot of map information and IDs of where the Lowland Lions players were going to be. I mean, you can pretty much conclude already, they're not going to be coming short, they're not going to be going to mid, they're not going to be coming towards those B tunnels. And that's a huge advantage.
Yeah, so now are we going to go into round 3? What do you expect the guys to buy and to do? Because it's going to be probably eco round versus guns. Is this going to be the round that everything is going to flip around? Because that seems to be the meta in the Benelux.
To be fair, Lone Grind's actually had a bomb plant, so that is a big deal. That allows them for a very solid buy as well. In the third round, they're going to have a lot of Molotovs. So that means that Lone Grind's can actually do their execute. And when Lone Grind's can do their executes, that's when they're dangerous. Because the experience they have, like I said before, they play against the big teams as well. And I believe it's the Operation Kingwind tournament, which is one of the bigger tournaments in CS, actually. So this could be bad news for Astarion. On the other hand, Astarion have guns as well, but they're probably not going to opt to force to upgrade those farm masters, which means that against an AK, you're actually at a big disadvantage.
So yeah, you're talking about all the experience of Lone Lions and their experience compared to other teams. What does that experience bring to the table? Is it team tactics? Because the individual skill seems to be all right looking at the first two rounds being played.
I think it's just all in all the chemistry of the game, the team play. The chemistry is really important if you play together for a long time, and if you play together in all have experienced teams, then you can develop this chemistry faster with one another. And if you don't have that chemistry, it's harder, because then your communication needs to be on point. Whereas if you have good chemistry, you don't need to have perfect communication, because you kind of know, like, okay, I need to cover this point because he's going to fall back without even saying it.
So is that experience with playing together, tournaments, going in, going out. So that's good for a group stage of 7 weeks to get to know each other and learn some tactics up to this finale. But looking at the individual skill of Astarion, they also have players that play together for a pretty long time, right?
Yeah, the likes of Slain, Lewis, Raven, and Amos, they have actually played together before in the AT Gaming Black lineup, which was actually before their previous lineup, which was Mouse Control. And in Mouse Control, it was actually Slain, Amos, and Kinzo that played together. So these players actually have a lot of experience playing with each other. The point is, though, that you have like the team experience that you get as a team, and like Rick said, the chemistry. But there's always like just the regular experience in the game itself, and that is where Lone Lions, they really shine. Especially the likes of Kai's King. He's had so much experience in CS in general, because he was actually a big player in Source and in 1.6 as well, which really benefits him here, especially playing on the stage like this. This is basically a walk in the park for him. He's going to feel almost no pressure.
No pressure. That is very important, to play more relaxed than your opponent. So yeah, we're still looking for the server to get started and the place to get into the game. We cannot see the buys for the next game, but I expect it to be guns. So what do you think that Lone Lions will be planning here? Are they gonna rush A or B with pistols, five men, and how aggressive is Astarion going to defend? Because that was normally the problem with the teams defending too aggressive with those guns, running into those pistols, and, well, denying them the win of the round themselves.
Well, I think it's all about going to be who's going to see the first man. I mean, that's kind of obvious to say. Passive, aggressive defense could be the good counter-threat for the pistol Glocks. Stay away from them. Don't get close. I mean, you have got rifles. Why would you go close? And that's really perfect for us too. I mean, you can sit back.
Astarion are going to scout. They're going to see where the player is coming from. They want to see them as fast as possible, because if Lone Lions sneak up to them with a five-man team, they can, well, take the round with just pistols and get on the board. So it looks like the game is live. So let's get back into the semifinals of Lone Lions versus Astarion.
So yeah, we're going to see a pistol round here. Lone Lions opting not to buy guns, because that will allow them for a very good buy on the next round. And they're actually going to take it slow. Molva has that deagle and armor to work with, so maybe he can do some damage with that. He's going to make his way up towards Cat, and is not going to spot anyone just yet. I like the very passive setup that Astarion are holding this time. They're not going for those close battles here on the shore. Like we said before, that is the mistake often players make, that they pick up those close range battles, especially when they're playing against the SMGs and pistol. So, Mole still here on the push towards A. He's going to make his way up short, going to spot ahead there. He's going to make his way through. Has Mole been spotted, though? He knows now that there's a player in CT. He's really going to peek out towards A long. Is he going to spot Mole? Kinzo, yes, he will. Bring a little one deke there. Can he land a second? No, well, Fasher in the meantime, picking up three quick frags there. Mono, Arrow, and Crucial instantly get down, and then now it's Mole with 37 HP over towards that A site. In a world of trouble, Kai's King will get a P250 frag. We'll get two P250 frags actually onto his Ravel and Skane, and now it's all evened up. And Amos and Fesher, look at the HP on Amos and Fesher. This is a very winnable round for Golden Lions right now. And Amos and both Fasher need to be very careful about their next steps. However, the bomb is down towards Long though. Fasher has control of that bomb. Amos will mop up the remaining two kills there. Get the third round on the board, but that is a lot of rebuys here for Asterion, Rick.
Yeah, it's very poor from Asterion how Mole was just allowed to walk on A shore without any sort of resistance. Fair enough, he got spotted, but where was the call then? I mean, Mole, he was on that A side, he had a clear shot, he had plenty of time to connect that headshot as well. And then Kai's King picking up two kills with P250, that's just absolutely insane. And now, Fasher as well, picking up three players as well in that round, which is a fantastic play. He's sitting on 8 frags already. Three rounds, that's impressive. Well, at the moment, we'll have a standard approach from the lower lines, pretty much taking that mid control and going for that slow approach. Let's see if Kai's King is going to be able to unlock something there. Going to go with three players on short. And again, I don't see a lot of defense here from Asterion to stop that push from A short. And Molly did come out to stop that approach just a little while. And now that one CT is going to go on that side.
And it is Goose Ravel indeed, falling back towards the ramp. He is going to be the man that is going to hold the defense here. And he actually spotted a player dropping down into CT. He's going to toss out a pop flash, going to flash himself as well. But he's going to flash Aaron in the process. Will pick up the first, the headshot onto Aaron. The A push still is on, though. Kai's King was in that CT as well. Kai's King picks up two. That is the aggressive play we like to see from him, and it's paying off once more for the Golden Lions. Bomb has gone down now. It's a retake for the Asterion boys, and will they go for it? They have two kits to work with. They still have a Molotov on Fasher. This could be a retake for them, but yeah, it's not going to happen when Monu picks up a kill like that. Swain will get taken down out of the equation. Amos in the meantime replies with one, but Monu and Crucial will mop up the remaining frag, putting the first round on the board here for the Golden Lions.
And that is, again, Kai's King delivering for the team, picking up two kills, entries, and bam, Shazam, Golden Lions pick up their round, and that's the good round as well. So, and now having that AWP in Crucial hands, let's see what he's going to be able to do with it. I mean, he's having a nice spawn. They're only up against pistols as well. Crucial's going to peek out. He's going to be facing a couple of smokes here. And some aggression being shown. It's Kai's King again leading the way for Lowland Lions. And it's going to be in a long setup. Kind of slow approach here. We do have one player still lurking around. It's going to be Monu. And Mole is your in-game leader for Lowland Lions, so he's going to be making those calls and telling what those boys should be able to do here. And looks like they are going to be approaching that side. Asterion still lying in wait. Fasher as well, sitting in such a keen corner. But the first frag has fallen. Slain will pick himself the first frag. Kinzo goes down straight after by Kai's King again. And Fasher won't be able to deliver this time. He's going to get barbecued by Crucial. Crucial minding himself another one or two of those. And now Slayin and Lewis Ravo. It's all that remains for Asterion. Lewis Ravo picks himself up a deagle onto Mole. Still three more to find, though. The bomb has been blown, which is not a good thing. Lewis Ravo down to 27 HP. Well, do you see it happening, Dins?
I don't see it happening, to be fair. Lewis Ravo, all he wants to do now is just do some more damage. He knows that he's not going to opt to save this deagle like super badly, so this actually it's a battle against Aaron towards the back of mid there. Gonna drop down to 14 HP from that bomb explosion. Kai's King will take him down. Selene is actually going to save that AK, and that is actually a big deal. That is a good stuff here for the Asterion boys, because that means that Selene only has to buy up armor, or can even drop that AK to one of his teammates, and maybe he can go for a glass cannon. Well, it's Goose Raver that's going to go for the glass cannon. And that is, we've seen Lewis Ravo up before, we've seen him do great stuff, but can he fight off Crucial with that AWP? Crucial has brought his AWP towards B there, it's gonna rattle off a shot, it's gonna miss Swain. Swain is gonna realize now that There's at least one player towards the back of tunnels there. He's going to rattle off some shots. Crucial actually dropped down at 37 HP. He has that AWP, so he only needs to hit one shot. So that is, of course, he's not the worst player to have low HP on. Let's put it like that. And as of right now, they are setting up towards the back of mid. There's going to be a flashbang out those mid doors. Mid doors are actually going to get smoked off instantly there by Asterion. So right now, it's a more passive setup here for Leon Grimes. Looks like they will be setting up for a mid to B. Crucial is ready there with that smoke. Fasher is over towards short. Amos is holding mid there alongside Luz Ravo. Mid to B smokes are coming out now. Oh, Luz Ravo lands a beautiful wallbang there onto Crucial as he pushed in. Luz Ravo will land a second there at the Kai's King. Fasher also picks up a frag, but Aaron will take down Luz Ravo, who is opping in that CT side. Right now, 2-on-4, Aaron and Monu are up against 4 angry CTs, and Monu will get dropped. Kinzo will be the man to take him out, and in the end, Slain will mop up Aaron, making that the 4th round for Asterion. Actually, a very good round as well for Asterion. Luz Ravo showing his power with that AWP.
Yeah, and this is so nice for Asterion as well. I mean, this was Lula Lion's mid-aggression, and they managed to stop it. That smoke as well, and that double kill from Luz Ravo definitely put Lula Lions back into their seats and back into their hole, like absolutely the night by Asterion. So very well played. But now it is Lula Lions again, going for a bit of a force buy. You got Bull and Monu with both nines. And a lot of aggression in mid. We see Kai's King picking himself the first kill onto Kinzo. Will he follow up though? It was dangerous. Fasher nearly to go down. And his side seems to be having a bit of trouble here for Asterion. Fasher is going to throw out a Molotov, hopefully to slow it down, but it kind of didn't work out well for him. Now the bombs be planted by Lola Alliance. And that's gonna have the timer ticking away in their favor. Monu's gonna finish off Amos with the Tech 9 headshot. And, well, it's a 3-on-5. Should Asterion just save with what they have?
Yeah, they, in a situation like this, they should. They have two kits, but still, they have, like, Lone Lions have such firm control of that siding. You actually see that Asterion are already in a saving position. Especially because Luz Ravo has that AWP, it's a super valuable gun. Luz Ravo will actually pick up a frag down onto Aaron. That makes his position known, though, so that's going to put him in a little bit of danger. He is backed away far enough, though. He's going to save that AWP in the... Oh, Slain. He's going to escape with his life there. Monu will take him down with the Tech 9. Fashion will pick up one before it gets dropped by Kai's King. But still, that is the AWP drop there from Luz Ravo. This is going to be either a force-up or a force buy. I mean, an eco round here. Luz Ravo has that AWP, looks like. Will Asterion will be on the full eco here. They're not going to opt to buy up those pistol armor setup.
Well, it's going to be Kai's King again to pick up a first kill into Moe's and straight into this B side. It's going to be Fasher that's facing a lot of trouble and a lot of heat as well. Lola Lions are going to just check out Molly. It's going to leave Fasher just within a world of trouble. He can't really deny his bomb plant as the bomb's now being planted. It's going to be a 3-on-5 after plant situation. And I'm sure Fasher was going to try and go for it. But Kai's King again just proves to be too strong with the AK, shuts him down. And Kinzo with the pistol might just go for an exit frag. Luz Ravo is definitely going to save that AWP, and that's, you know, all justified. But losing that B side to the Lola Alliance aggression is just, it's just harsh for Asterion. Luz Ravo does pick up a two-man here. Crucial and Kai's King down. We're trying to hunt it down, and that AWP does get shut down by Aaron. So that's very well played here by Lola Alliance, getting that that AWP out of the equation for the next round.
Yeah, we're probably just going to see some small pistols here. Luz Ravo going to opt for a Deagle. Some armor here on the Fasher and Kinzo actually going for the body armor and Deagle combination. Amos going with the Deagle as well, just Slain on the 5-7. We've seen one of the pro teams do this a lot as well. It's Envious. They opt to go for a lot of Deagles as well. It's something that happened a lot more often in the 1.6 scene as well. It was called Deco. You were basically doing a Deagle Eco. The problem in the CSGO is that the Deagle is a little bit more random, so you can't really like count on it. It has a lot more RNG, so that is why it is still more rare to see in those eco rounds. Crucial will pick up a frag there with that AWP on the screen. Of course, this is a full eco, so this is not going to be the hardest round here. The Rolling Vines, but still, need to get out relatively unscathed. Aaron is going to make his way through those mid doors after Ulz Raven got fully flashed. That is going to secure them the second kill of the round, and that gives the advantage firmly through the Rolling Vines boys, also in numbers. Right now, Aaron is going to make his way up towards Cactpool, pick up a brilliant headshot down to Fasher, doesn't even get time to respond. Aaron's going to clear out the rest of CT. Going to make sure no one is lurking at those corners. Kinzo will get dropped by him as well with a nice little headshot there at the end. There's a very clean round actually for the Rolling Lions. They do not drop a player. That means the economy is now building for them, Rick.
Yeah, and this is going to be very dangerous here for Asterion. I mean, once the Rolling Lions have that lead, they tend to maintain it.
Sure.
We've seen this in the past, like Lola Lions. Once they get away, it's a steep roll. But we're not there yet. Slayin and Ulz Raven going for a double AWP setup, so gonna be interesting. I mean, Lola Lions have been showing aggression. I think it's a risky thing to do, especially when Lola Lions tend to go with four or either five men into a site, and then with just a single AWP, you're not gonna be doing much, especially with a lot of flashbangs coming out. But it doesn't seem to be the case at the moment. Lola Lions going for a bit of a split push, looking for an opening on the A short side. Kai's King this time a little bit reluctant to go first. He's gonna allow Crucial to just jiggle peek around. Kinzo sitting in the goose spot, having a good time. And well, looks like Lola Lions do want to set up for that mid approach yet again. And Ulz Raven, having adjusted his position, it's going to be a most watching that assault once it does happen. But again, Lola Lions just can't seem to be finding anyone, so it's a bit of a risky play. They want to commit to something here, but yeah, what's going to happen? I mean,
yeah, they're probably setting up for a mid to B right now. Smokes are going to come out. CT is going to get smoked once more. Amos now finding himself sandwiched alongside his teammates. Slain, they need to focus on one of these two angles, and Maul will actually pick up the first frag there. Amos tries to reply, but Aaron will take him down before he can take down his teammates. So that is now the B side completely in the hands of the Rolling Lions. Asterion replies, though. Ulz Raven will get a nice little AWP headshot still. So 3-on-4 with only a kid on Fasher. Are they going to save once more? It looks like that will actually be the case. Fasher is just going to play backline, going to try and do some economical damage. But at this point, the Rolling Lions have such a strong economy as well. It is not going to matter all that much. Ulz Raven will get another frag there onto Aaron, who was exiting outside of the B side. Fasher with a frag as well. Kai's King down and out. And now it is just all eco damage. Right now, Kinzo will drop Mono as well. Now it's Mole finds himself towards those upper tunnels. He's gonna leap around, not gonna take any chance. He wants to hold on this AWP. Good economy damage there from Asterion, but still, they don't pick up the round, which is, of course, not the thing you want to go for, Rick.
And, I mean, that's again Lola Lions with that mid-aggression, and this time we didn't see Ulz Raven having a crossfire with Amos. I think that's a little bit of a problem when you have an AWP and mid on such a short range that Lola Lions are going to be able to capitalize on it. And, well,
the main problem with a mid to B is you basically have one of two choices. You either play two people in the B side and you hold off one of the approaching side towards B. That's actually what Asterion tried to do. Slain tried to win the AWP fight there over towards the tunnel, but he lost the battle. That left Amos completely sandwiched. He had to make a push. Didn't work out. Because Ulz Raven had an AWP, he's also not able to jump on the box in CT and basically go in the Freakazoid spot and hold off the pushers towards B. So it's just, it's a really rough situation when you have an AWP playing middle. You're going to have a really hard time defending those mid to B strats.
Well, Lola Lions, they're really a slow team at the moment. They didn't really go for this fast aggression. They tend to go at the 40-second mark and then just completely go all out. And can definitely see now they're pretty much on that A short side. Four players there, Maul is going to be lurking around. And Kinzo is going to hear those players, all of them, coming down on that A side. Ulz Raven with his eyes peeled on the A short. Will pick himself the first round. Kai's kicked down. Oh, not going to be able to connect that second one. And it's a two for two trade. But Molu
He's gonna pick up his own double here, and that's gonna again open up that bomb site, and the bombs will be planted now. Will Asterion go for that defuse slay in here? Gonna try and begin his assault. He's gonna play his right there, but it's gonna be again Monu shutting him down. AK shot to the heads, all left up to Fasher. 1-on-3, it's looking pretty grim for him. Gonna pop flash in. And it's gonna happen. Mo will take him out. And that's gonna be Lola Lions picking himself up another round. 7-4. And that's a 3-round deficit here for Lola Lions and for Asterion, sorry.
Asterion started off really good. They actually won a gun round as well. But right now you can see the power of the Lone Lions. Like, the problem right now is when the Lone Lions execute, because of the weak economy here for the Asterion boys, they don't have the Molotovs and the flashbangs to block them. Like, they threw a smoke on short just now. There was no Molotov to block their push, so they basically could just walk in the side. And because the Lone Lions guys, they have good aim, so they're gonna shoot you in the face when you're peeking from ramp. So Kinsel was in a really good position to, for example, throw a Molotov. He just doesn't have the money for that kind of utility, so you're gonna have a really hard time against those full executes from the Lone Lions. And I just like the way the Lone Lions are approaching this now. They're playing so passive. They're playing like super composed. They're not making any mistakes. They're not making the mistakes they made in a group stage. That having said, Asterion is playing a lot better as well. But as I said, that Asterion right now, like, to be fair, Aaron picking up the headshot there, that is a push that had to be made, because you're down as a CT, you're 4v5, you need to make a push, you need to even it up, or even get two kills. Right now, that's exactly what Amos is doing. He will pick up two brilliant headshots there. Aaron and Monu down, that's the bomb down as well. And Amos, is he gonna continue his push in those lower tunnels? Yes, he will, but Crucial will take him down with a AWP. That is a good revenge frag there, allowing him to pick up that bomb. And that is now the B-side firmly in the hands of the Lone Lions. Fasher is gonna be the danger man who is going to be defending said B-bomb side. Bomb is gonna go in. Is Fasher gonna try and go for the aggression? He will pick up Kai's King. Doesn't land the second shot there onto Mole. There's now a 1-on-2 situation. Lewis Rafe will make that a 1v1. He is now in a 1v1 against Crucial. Up on our battle right now. Crucial is super low. Can he pick up this round? It is Who's Rave who's now sneaking around. He's gonna rattle off a shot. Not going to connect though. He will land the pistol headshot. And that is a brilliant round there for Lewis Raver. Clutching it 1v2 once more. 5-7 now your scoreline. And this is exactly the kind of power that Lewis Raver can deliver.
Oh, can you believe it? Lewis Raver goes absolutely huge. And would you believe it? I mean, Lola Lions, with two players on the side, you'd say they would be able to lock it down fairly easily. But Lewis Raven picking up that kill from the backside, brilliant. And now then making it a 1-on-1. That was also a tough situation as well for Crucial, to be fair. With such low HP, Lewis Raven could just pull out his pistol and one shot was enough. So Asterion trying to close the gap here, and Crucial opening things up. Gonna take out Kinzo with that ADLP shot. And looks like Lewis Rave's flashed off. Fasher is gonna take one out, but Kai's King immediately will reply into Fasher. A bit of a taste of his own medicine. And now it's a 3-on-4. It's gonna be a very difficult situation here for Lewis Rave, with Little Alliance decide to go for that A side. Crucial here. Just spamming away through that smoke. Oh wow, Lewis Raven returns the favor. Now down to 3-on-3 with back even Stevens. And Lola Lions gonna still go for the day side, knowingly that Asterion still have to rotate towards there, as Lewis Raven is still looking for more blood. Gonna go for the jump shot, does miss out on that one, but will deny that plant, and that's all that matters. Getting a bit of more time on that clock.
Yep, getting a little bit more time indeed. This is now Kai's King, Mole, and Monu. They just have to deny Asterion to do more damage to them. Amos is gonna peek out towards the A-long there. Are they actually gonna go for this? They have a kid on screen. Are they gonna try and retake this? Monu is towards the back of that side. Mole will peek around with that AWP. Slain will take down Monu. It's now a 1v1. Amos finding himself in a 1v1. Will land the shot there onto Kaiski. Will he be in time for the defuser? No, he won't. Amos didn't pick up the kid. He doesn't have time. Is he gonna pick up this AWP and just save it? Just for at least saving his face a little bit there. He didn't pick up the kid, as Slain was behind him when he got dropped by Mole. That is so unlucky there. Nice little reflex from Amos, but couldn't close out the round. That is just so unlucky there. And the Logan Lions will pick up their 8th round break.
Yeah, I mean, it's unfortunate. Like, you're in such an unfortunate soul if you get three kills and then not gonna be have enough time to defuse that bomb. And, well, it's looking pretty grim. Looks like Lewis Raybo has got himself that ADRP, but yeah, Assyrian couldn't be able to afford anything and buy off the back of that. And now Lil and Lions are pretty much allowed the free entry. Good here, Kaisking is gonna shut down Fasher and almost dust down Moby, but the bomb has been planted. It's a 4-on-4 after plant situation. I don't think Asterion should be going for it. Maybe going for a couple of exit frags and get some guns into their hands.
Yeah, like Asterion right now, they're gonna be money screwed on the next round anyway. Like, the problem right now is you see a lot of their players being around 1.4k, 1.5k. They're gonna have a very crappy buy. Lewis Raybo really needs to save this AWP, and Amos really needs to save this AK in order for them to have at least a semi-decent buy into the next one. So they will pick up a frag onto Aaron, will pick up a second frag onto Crucial as well. On Maul will land the frag onto Slain, though. These guns are being saved by Amos and Lewis Raybo. That is an AWP and an AK. But, it is, now a sort of decent buy here for Asterion. Fasher will pick up that slightly better gun. Slightly worse gun, I should say. Not better, worse. Right now, there's a very calm setup once more from the long guns. We've seen this pay off for them so many times. And it is very much their strong point as a team as well. They like stack up so well. They play this very good default, then they go into this full execute, which Asterion just can't stop. Lewis Raybo, oh, just get tagged up there by that was Crucial, came around the corner. Lewis Raybo fully had the advantage there. Did get flashed though, but still. Crucial with a very, very nice tag there. But still, the advantage in the hands of Asterion, it looks like it will be again admit to be Strat. It just worked out so many times for them. Aaron will land the shot there onto Amos. Slain will reply though onto Aaron. He is defending this bomb site with his life. Slain almost lands a second. That lands the dink actually on Maul. Drops him down to 15 HP. 3-on-2 situation right now. Maul is on low HP and Monu still on full HP with that AK. Kinzo's battling off some shots through that smoke. Who's Ravo's gonna take down Monu. He tries to run to that site. And now it is all on Maul with that big green gun. As of right now. Chances of him winning this round are very slim, Rick. Is a 1v3. If he can pull this off, oh, that's gonna be great. He lands the first, though, onto Lewis Raybo. That is a nice little shot there. Of course, he has that AWP. He only needs one shot. Doesn't land a second on the Fasher, though. And that is 6-9, Rick. That is your first half here being won by Logan Lions. Of course, the T-side being slightly favored here on Dust2. And that means now the Asterion boys have it all to do. They need to pick up this pistol round, Rick, to in order to stay close here.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, if Lone Lions picked up that round, then Asterion would have been in real trouble. That would be meaning a 5-round lead. But now it's only a 3-round lead. I mean, like you said, if Asterion picked himself the pistol round, it's still very doable. And especially on that T side, you can show the aggression. You can dictate the base of the game like Lone Lions have been doing. I mean, if Asterion can mimic that kind of play style, then it's still very possible to pick up that first map for Asterion. But Lowland Lions, they are going to be setting up a solid defense naturally. And a bit of action happening here. Kaisking yet again. He's really been getting these first blots. And that's going to be Lewis Raybo down and out. And, well, so far no response from Asterion saying that Fasher will find himself a frag on the Crucial, but Maul will reply quickly on the Fasher. So that's really Lone Lions getting themselves those trade kills in, which Asterion sometimes seem to be struggling with on their CT. But however, it's still the pistol round. Anything can happen. The Kai's King picking himself with a double kill on that cross, laying down Akinzo, and Kai's King with the fall frag. And that's the most down and out. It's going to be the round going for Lone Lions. 10-6. What a play by Kai's King.
That is insane. That is insanity. Like, we've seen Fasher do this on CTE, and Kai's King is just like, okay, you can do that. I can do that as well. Let me show you how it's done. And that is exactly what he does. Kai's King is also going to opt now for one of the best guns now, the M4. And as of right now, Staryon are on the full eco. That is bad news. Wow. Look at Crucial and Monu plowing through these Staryon players. Crucial picking up three before he drops to the pistol of Amos. And Amos now is in a 1v4 with no armor and a lot of angry CTs to fend off. Eren will mop up that remaining frag. That is the 11th round here for Rogue Lions. Staryon still looks like they're actually going to go for the bot. Okay.
Well, that was a bit of a high-risk, high-reward round, wasn't it? Again, for Lola Lions, showing aggression like that and Crucial. I mean, it does pay off this time. Not always, we've seen it before, but Lola Crucial increasing his bank account by a lot with those SMG frags, now allowing for a bit of an upgrade. But Asterium, they're going to be setting up for something cheeky. We can't say everything here. But Lola Lions holding steady as the Asterion boys will slowly approach. What is the thing? What's gonna happen here? We can see everything.
Yeah, this could go very, very badly here for Staryon. That is exactly what's gonna happen. Eren will pick up three quick frags there with that MP7, and that is that full B push denied. The bomb is outside of B. They're locked out of this side. This is bad, bad news, Rick. Amos and US Raven now have it all to do, and Amos is actually gonna land the shot there through that smoke. 4-on-2 right now. And it is rough times here for Staryon. So Wall still just spamming through that smoke. Trying to land some shots. Who's Raven's doing the same, but from the other side. And it is 30 seconds left on the clock. Bomb, like I said, is out. Oh, Crucial will take out Raven with that AWP. And now it's all an Amos. Can he go clutch? Can he pull this back? Would be crazy if he did. He can't. Kai's King will land the headshot there. What a hole there from I believe that was, yeah, that was Eren, right?
Yeah. I mean, Crucial getting a triple kill the last two rounds, and now Eren doing the same thing. Lola Lions now leading by 6 rounds. I mean, it must be feeling so good for them. And Asterion, at the moment, not really having an answer. And maybe that's not the right thing to do when you have SMGs being on point. Eren and Crucial both delivering, and maybe going for a bit of a split push might work out. For Asterion might be working out much better, but yeah, now Asterion a bit of a problems having not much of an eco, whereas Lola Lions, they've been building their bank account, so they're gonna definitely be feeling confident even if they were to lose this round, which I doubt is gonna happen because they're pretty geared up. But Monu will find himself the first frag. That's pretty much gonna confirm what's gonna happen here. Lose Rave is gonna be shut down, and Kai's King here, and Monu finding himself with the 3-man here and casually walking away.
That is just so clean. And you can look, like, if you look at the economy right now for Lola Lions, it is insane. Like, they have so much money built up because they played so many clean rounds, you know. And that is just, especially on the CT side, where the economy is very rough. Like, when you lose players, you force those rebuys, M4s, and full armor sets and nades are expensive. I mean, when you play on T side, the AK is like 2.7k. When you buy an M4, it's 3.1. A Molotov on CT side is 600. On T side, it's 400. Like it's just CT economy is very rough. Right now, the B push is on from the Asterion boys. They have that bomb down. Now they need to play keenly in this off the plan situation. Fashion will take down Kai's King before he saw Lewis Raver drop to him. Whoa. Come around the corner, land the headshot there onto Fasher. It's now a 2-on-3. This is a very, very, very rough position to be in here. But Kinzo and Amos combined, will they pick up this clutch? It is now Crucial will land the no-scope there onto Amos. He knows where the last player is gonna drop down that smoke. Is he gonna stick it? Oh, he's actually gonna move out of the smoke and take down Kinzo. That is a 1v2 clutch with brilliant play there from Crucial. Uses the smoke to his advantage, conceals his position, and comes out at the right time. And Kinzo just has no answer for it.
Well, if there was any time for Asterion to come back. It was right there, but Crucial absolutely denied them that, stomped them into the ground. And that is Lil and Lions really pulling ahead now, 14-6. If Asterion don't pick up this round, it's gonna be over for this map. So, Crucial, feeling confident and happy, gonna go for a bit of a peeking here, but Kaisky finds himself the fast crack, and Moe's quickly to reply as well. Slade shutting down Moe. And now, it is Asterion to make their way towards the side. Crucial, though, is going to deny them together with Molu shutting down Basher. Crucial finding himself another one. This man is on fire. Slaying your last man standing in a 1-on-2. Will he be able to pull it off? It is going to be Aaron and Crucial against the one player called Slane. Slane now approaching it, but Crucial is gonna land another shot. And it is again Crucial going absolutely ham. Three frags for Crucial, 15-6. It's gonna be a map point for Lola Lions. An absolutely insane play by the Opera from Crucial. Doing great work.
Like, the Lola Lions are so firmly in the lead that Crucial doesn't even need to go ham like this, you know, but he does. And he's just so good with that AWP. Like, his pinpoint accuracy, he's really showing why he's one of the best offers in the Benelux here. And Kai's King, in the meantime, he is also showing us why he is one of the best riflers in the Benelux, as he picks up two quick frags there onto Slane and Kinzo right now. That just denies Asterion. Like, they don't have the numbers advantage now. And that is just, well, especially when Fasher is trying to pick up a gun like that. Crucial will take him down. Wizraven will whip around into Crucial there. Wizraven looking down mid with that AWP. 4-on-2 situation right now. Wizraven is going to rattle off some shots still through that smoke. Not going to connect with any of the CTs, though. Bomb is over on his teammate. Right now, it is a very, very slow-paced round. It has become, because Asterion, they need to play their cards right. They need to play like super, super keen. And Lone Lions, they don't have to push. I mean, basically, every situation right now, if they play 2-2, they're going to be safe.
Yeah, it's definitely that Asterion have to show the aggression now, and looks like they are going to be doing it. However, it is Lone Lions that playing super passively, and it looks like they might just be going for that retake. Kai's King with a ridiculous headshot to lose Rainbow. Aaron's gonna finish off a Moe's after Moe's did take out Maul, but it's not gonna matter anymore. It's gonna be 16-6.
Is there any stopping this man? Is there any stopping right now of Kai's King, who has ripped apart Asterion on this first map? It has been insane, especially alongside Crucial as well. They just deliver so much power, and right now, Asterion just don't have an answer for it.
Yeah, that was an insane first game. We saw great individual performances of Fasher. We saw Kai's King. We saw Crucial, the players that we talked about and predicted that they would stand up their game, show off, and wow, what an insane performance from Crucial there.
Yeah, that was insanity. Like, especially because with the 1v2 he got, like, most of the times, the CT is going to play, like, he's going to toss down the smoke, he's going to defuse in the smoke. But what I really liked about Crucial is he went out of the smoke, used the angle to his advantage, and to be fair, he landed a pretty insane shot as Kinzo, because Kinzo even jumped. He jumped out of the tunnel, and Crucial just didn't care. It was like, oh, flick, you're done.
Yeah, well,
insane.
Yeah, the game started pretty good with Fasher having his own individual skills showing up there. And I was like, okay, Asterion got this, they're gonna start up the game. And then Lone Lion slowed the pace of the game and went very tactical, performed pretty well. And is this the moment where the team tactics are gonna outplay the individual skill?
Well, I think it certainly is. I mean, Lone Lion's, their defense was so solid. Like, Asterion, they were actually sometimes struggling. They were losing guns as well. Whereas Lone Lions, they kept their guns pretty much every single round. I think mostly they lost maybe two players, but most of the time just one or none at all, which allowed them for a good economy as well as in the individual players, the likes of Crucial picking up three kills with an SMG, allowing for a fast AWP buy and a comfortable buy as well, with enough utility to work with. And yeah, I mean, it was really Kai's King and Crucial going absolutely huge. Kai's King as well, pretty much entering every single time.
All right, so that was the first game of the semifinal between Lola Lions and Asterion. We're going to go into a very short break, and we'll be right back with the second map, and that will be Cash. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. ¶¶
is unreleased Monster Cat music.
This is Tut Tut Child. Welcome back to another episode of the Monster Cat Podcast. Just want to thank you all for the huge support you've given me on my new EP, Ask Your Friends First. Here's the opening track, Hot Pursuit. Enjoy.
Monster Cat. Welcome back to the Monster Cat Podcast. Subscribe. subscribe on iTunes to download this episode for free. Hashtag MonsterCat Podcast on Twitter and Instagram for your chance to be featured during our live stream each and every Tuesday. You are listening to the MonsterCat Podcast.
Okay guys, we are back with the semi-final. It's 1-0 for Lone Lions ahead of Asterion Gaming. It was an exciting first game with good individual performances from Lewis Ravo, from Thasher, from Crucial, from Kaisking. And guys, we're going to play on cash. What do you expect of this next game? Is it going to be equal? Is it going to be 1-1? Or is Lone Lions taking this game away?
To be fair, Dust 2 is one of the better maps of Asterion. If you lose 16-6, I believe it was, that is not just the point that you're not good at the map.
But you have to believe.
I have to believe, but you also have to be realistic. Like the point right now for me is that when you get destroyed 16-6, that is an indicator that you're not only lacking something on that map, you're lacking something as a team.
And is that just the team combination? You were talking about utility. We saw Lewis Ravo and Fasher doing great individual performances, but now you need the utility, the teamwork, and that is where they are lacking.
The point on Dust2 was that, for example, you had Kinzo playing CT at one point, and they were actually pushing Cat with three. He did some great stuff. He had one flashbang, which delayed the push, but he didn't have a Molotov to block off like the push towards the A site. And that was just throughout the whole game, because Asterion couldn't build economy because they're playing on CT side. That was the problem for them. They didn't have the nades, the Molotovs, and the smokes and the flashbangs to counter the actual good executes from Lone Lions.
So we saw the Lone Lions being a little bit passive, playing pretty slowly. Do you, as a Asterion, then go very aggressive and put pressure on them to make sure that they make faster plays? Or how do you counter this type of playstyle? Or do you expect even the Lone Lions to go in there with a more slow play?
It's always a bit of a trade-off. Like, Lone Lions, it's pretty much the idea of playing that slow. They're kind of measuring the defense on Dust2 by going slow, going for the slow approaches, but they are going pretty much as a group. You've always seen four players together around A short or mid or either A long, and then one player lurking around B, making sure no one is going to get in their back or does anything silly for them. And that is maybe a thing that you could do, cut off the lurker, and then you'll be able to find out a lot more about what Lone Lions are up to.
So this is practically an information game. You're looking for players, where are they, yeah. Where can I plant the bomb, are they going to come at 5 with 4, and if you pick off that lurker, you're going to be in a 4-5 situation. But we saw in that first game with the individual skill, it can be hard to, even in a 2v1 score,
well, with the clutch of Crucial.
Yep. Like, we've seen him do that more often, and that is where he actually showed that he is, I think, a tier above some of the Asterion players. Like, the way he played out that 1v2 was brilliant. We're actually already in the ninth round right now.
Yeah, we're going live with the second game of the semifinals between Lowland Lions and Asterion Gaming, so have fun, guys.
Yeah, well, the ninth round yet again has already been over, and it looks like Asterion will take that ninth round. And are they gonna stay on that T side? But it would be strange, wouldn't it?
Oh, I don't think they're gonna stay. They're gonna swap. Yep.
There we go.
That's what happens.
So Asterion again going for that defensive side.
Yep. Yeah, they tend to start on the defensive side. Let's see if Fasher can do as much damage in this pistol round once more. So let's see where he's gonna go. Oh, look at this. Key little push here. And it is going to be the bomb in the hands of, I believe that is Crucial. Yes, that is Crucial indeed. He has a bomb. Now setting up to execute on this side. Kinzo, though, and Lewis Raven combined with two frags onto Kai's King and Maul. The push is now on towards A. Now only Mono and Crucial alive. Crucial will get the headshot there onto Lewis Raven. Lewis Raven dropped his teammate in the meantime as well, though. We're onto a situation right now. And this is a rough situation for the Lone Lions to be. Bomb has gone down on Crucial. Will land another shot there. Headshot and a body shot to take Kinzo down. Now finding himself in a 1-on-3 situation. Gets spotted out, gets tagged. Oh, actually lands a brilliant headshot there on the Fasher. Now a 1v2, can't land a second there. Basically his third of the round there. Into Slain. Slain will pick that up. And again, Asterion actually pick up the first pistol round. We've seen them do this on Dust2 as well.
And again, it's going to be a promising setup for Asterion. I think also an interesting fact is to point out is that Lowland Lions haven't played cash yet.
Oh, no, they haven't. I mean, no, indeed. They haven't played cash throughout the whole group stage now, did they?
No. It's Asterion that played 3 times cash. They won 16-1 against Royal Lions, as well as 16-2 against SD Gaming. And then losing 11-16 against Venko. So once they do win, once they do get a hang of cash, they will absolutely exceed. And, you know, they might just be able to pull it off, but we're only into the second round, and Lowland Lions didn't get the bomb down, so that's a good thing for them, having a bit of money and being able to buy in that round. However, it's gonna be a bit of a slow, picky round here, and looks like the action is gonna commence. We got Fasher. Kinzo, though, picking himself the first SMG frag. Kinzo with a second one as Aaron goes down. Well, Crucial and Moe do reply with one frag each, and Kai's King's gonna shut down Fasher. And this is going sour air for Asterion, as now Slay on all his own, having to find two more plays. The bomb has yet to go down, though. And this is gonna be a very interesting situation here for Slay. And looks like it's going to be a very slow approach here for Lowland Lions. They're kind of measuring where Slain is going to be at.
And this round was basically the Benelux scene in a nutshell. Super scrappy, super puggy round. And looks like the pistols have reigned victorious so far. As I said, that still 1v2. Slain is going to spot Mole there. Dropped down to 8 HP. That is going to give away the position of Slain, though. And that means that Lowland Lions now have the choice of moving away from said player. Still though, Slain has full body armor and a helmet. He has a flashbang. And, let's see if he can do some damage. Can he pick up this 1v2? Just gonna try optimize his chances in this round. He really need this, but Kai's King will come around the corner and the headshot there. You can hear the player shouting here on stage. They are having the time of their life. They're keeping that motivation up. They're riling up the troops. That is the first round here for the Lone Lions. The anti-eco being won by them.
Yeah, well, we've talked about Lone Lions not winning those rounds, but Asterion is not a good thing. It's not a good sign for Asterion themselves. I mean, how are we gonna get any answer to this one now, Harold? a tricky situation for him then, as Steel showed a bit of aggression. Fasher is going to find himself the first frag of the round, dropping Monu. And Styrion, a bit of a more of aggressive play here. Looking out well, and Amo's having a bit of fire here. I mean, some fun, but not for long. Mo will shut him down. 4-4. Back even. And still Little Alliance a bit reluctant to go anywhere. Aaron's going to shut down Fash, who was pushing from that backside. To be like a very well Little Alliance round. This Kaisken will shut down Lewis Ravo as well. Slain and Kinzo. It's all that remains. And could this be a golden duo? As Kinzo still steadily firing off a couple of shots. There's still that one player in Spooky. And Little Alliance to perhaps approach their side and lock it out. What is that? Kais King's gonna ease it up for them as he drops his own teammate. Kinzo is now gonna capitalize it by dropping Maul. And Kinzo actually put himself in a really good position as he's now being able to shut down Crucial. It's all on Kais King. And Slaying here. Now coming in support, firing up a couple of shots. He has been flashed up. Kaisken got to push her out, but Kinzo luckily will take him out from the backside and will retrieve the AOP as well. It's going to be a 2-1 scoreline. Asterion surviving that round, but it's going to be their teeth.
Yep, and Kinzo showing his power there. 6-2. He's having a brilliant game so far, these early rounds. And right now, that puts Lions on a slightly awkward situation, money-wise. Right now, they are setting up to go for an aggressive play. And that is exactly what they will do. They have control of that, the position of the map. Oh, Crucial will land a 1 dig there onto Slain. His head gets taken clean off. Aaron replies, well, follows up, rather, onto Lewis Raver with that Tech 9. It's now a 4-on-3. Make that a, well, make that a 4-on-3. Yes, Kinzo will land that headshot there onto Crucial. Nice little shot there from Kinzo. Kinzo is being absolutely awesome so far. But still, the advantage is for the Lone Blind boys. It is Kinzo trying to make his way in here. Can he do so? And can he continue his dominance spree and keep his team in the round? The Fasher was actually going to spot a play in there. Aaron will take down Fasher, though. Kaisken will take down Kinzo. Now it's Amos finding himself on a 1v3. Well, make that a 1v2. Leaps out with the pistol. Doesn't land the shot there onto Mole. And Mole will take him down. And that is the second round here on the board for Lone. Like, these rounds are so puggy and so scrappy. Like, it is back and forth frags. And there's not really a full on execute going on so far.
Well, Lone Alliance just got on that side so fast that Asterion just got locked out of their own side, like, instantly. And for Asterion, it's so hard to retake a B-bomb side, especially just with one or two smokes. You can pretty much make sure that no one's going to be there for Asterion to take it back. Amos, though, had a good chance at it, had a good charge. I mean, picking up 2 kills, but that is about it. I mean, with a FAMAS, you can't really do that much at all. And again, Asterion are going to be well on the back foot in this round. Looks like Little Alliance with Kai's King find himself the first frag. This Kai's King again doing those entries really well. And Little Alliance playing really pathological here. Really the Little Alliance style. Taking control of certain areas, as we can't really call those out. But
yeah, the reason why we're not casting all the positions and the guns of the players is because the players can actually hear us on stage. So that is the reason why we are a little bit of, well, we're being a little bit more general in our position calling. Just to point that out there. As of right now, advantage still firmly in the hands of the Golden Lions here. As they are now opting to push on towards that side. Bomb is over there as well. They're going to meet up with 2 of the Asterion players, though. Kinzo will drop instantly as Aaron will rain dominance through that side. We'll pick up a Mose as well, who's Raven. I mean, we'll get a nice little Deagle headshot there to Kai's King. After that, he drops instantly to Aaron. And now it's all on Slain. 1v4 situation. You know, he has an, well, let us say, a lesser gun to work with. Gonna flash up some of the Golden Glass boys, but still, he's in a pickle to say the least. Can he survive with this SMG? No, he can't. Maul will take him down. The third round here for Lowland Lions, who have now put Asterion on a some sort of awkward money situation.
Yeah, and what would you say, Dins? Is it, like, really worth it? I mean, buying those Deagles against a fully equipped Lone Alliance team in that round. I mean, Lone Alliance had all the utility to work with, and only Deagles for Asterion. I mean, you can get lucky with it, but that's really not going to happen when Lone Alliance are showing consistency.
To be fair, one of the strong points of the Asterion boys are that they actually have strong aim. You have Kinzo, you have Fasher, you have Amos, who all have like loose rainbow as well. Basically, all of the players have super strong aim. So if you get two or three 1Ds, maybe even slightly lucky 1Ds, you're going to turn around the round. And that is why I think buying those Deagles is worth it. Meantime, USP Frag has actually gone down into crucial fashion with a second USP Frag down onto Kaiski. Mole will reply though, onto his teammate Slay, and Fashion will drop to Mole as well. So, a little reply there for Mole, which is now on towards the side. Aaron is going to come around that corner, will take down Amos, who was lurking in the corners of the side there. This is now a 1-on-3 situation for Lewis Raven. Will land the first there with that pistol once more. He lands the... Wow, what a... That smoke shot, Rick. What was that?
Lewis Raven coming alive.
Once more. So, wow, that was... couldn't close out the round, though. That is a little bit of a sad story. But, yeah. 4-2, and right now, we see... Who's really going for the glass cannon?
I mean, yeah, if he's that confident, I mean, that worked out well the last round when once he picked up an AOP and it was dropped by Crucial, I believe. But Lewis Raven, they're with the AOP looking for the first possible victim. So far, so good. As Lone Alliance are going to be setting up for sort of an execute here. As Asterion, not entirely sure that I agree with what they're doing. Obviously, we can't call it out just yet, but Lone Alliance are going to be checking out a couple of grenades, a couple of smokes, and here with Fasher just absolutely destroyed by Crucial. How did Crucial expect Fasher to be out there? And now it's here at Moe's finding himself one frag, going to get shot down by Kaisking. But Slain will quickly reply, so it's a 2-for-2 trade here for both the teams. But it's an off-the-plant situation, 3-on-3. It's a very difficult one for Asterion. And we're still hoping for Asterion to come back from this deficit. Kinzo will look to do just that as he shuts down Kaisking. Erwin, though, does reply with a frag onto Slain, 2-on-2. Kinzo will find himself 1-onto Crucial. As it's down to Erwin, 1-on-2. The UK man drops Kinzo. And he's got Lewis Raven to find with. Lewis Raven is actually going to take out the bomb. Arrow comes rushing out. It's going to fall into the crosshairs of Lewis Raven. Very well played by Asterion. Picking up that round and a well-needed round as well. Now making it 4-3.
And to be fair, the problem with that round was the afterplan setup for Lone Alliance. Aaron was in a good position in their main, picked up one frag, but the bomb was planted in the default spot in the corner of the side, which basically rendered Aaron like in such a bad position. Because he had to come out there, and Lewis Raven knew that. The reason why Aaron aggressed was because there's a 50% chance that he's going to stick it. So you just need to run to that side, and it's just such a bad position to be in then. In the meantime, those Slain, wow, two frags with that FAMAS. To do damage like that with a gun like that is actually a big deal, and it is now the advantage in the hands of the Asterion boys. Right now, is Kinzo. Take down Mole as well. Can't land the second frag onto Aaron. Still, does land the dink. Right now, it is a 3-on-2 situation. It is a slower round right now. The pace has been slowed down. Man. Them B-hops. The B-hops from Crucial there. And it is Crucial finding himself in a 1v3. He knows where Lewis Raven is. Raven just rattled off some shots. Lewis Raven knows where he is as well. So, Crucial has returned fire. Checking the right angle though. This is an op on op battle. Lewis Raven is not taking any chances. I like how Lewis Raven is playing this. He's just baiting him out. Just being a nuisance towards that side there. It keeps Crucial occupied. At least it should. And now, and a shot once more.
firing off a shot.
Now he knows that he's actually being pushed. Periscope is 1v3. Amos will pick up the remaining frag there, and I like how Luis Ravo played that. He was just so annoying in that side, like shooting the wall banging, basically always drawing the attention of Crucial. Crucial could never take his eyes off that side.
And it's pretty much your objective as in a 1v3 for Crucial, just to take out one player and make it down to 1v2, make it a little bit easier for himself, but then again, his position was known. I mean, all these players were going to surround him. I like the fact that Assyrian were, you know, patiently playing out that round and not going aggressive and, you know, would die in a silly way. And it's good that Assyrian did that. Not losing any more players than necessary. But yeah, it's now Lil and Lions having a bit of a pressure here, economy-wise, perhaps. But aggression is going to come out. Luis Ravo is going to find himself too out of nowhere. Arrow and Amonu down. Amonu's going to quickly follow up with a frag and a ball as Amonu went to triple. Brilliant play by the player. 5-4, Amonu. Absolutely wrecking Lowland Lions.
And that is such a morale boost. You can hear the players as well. They're screaming, they're shouting. Right now, they're feeling it. Because when you get a multi-frag like that, you're going to feel good about yourself. And your teammates are going to feel good about you as well. And that is just like
bit of a motivational boost that's always needed. And especially as well, I mean, confidence is really that Assyrian is going to need after having such a big loss of those two. But I'm glad they can leave it behind. I'm glad they're now focused on cash.
Yeah, indeed. And like you said, confidence is such a big factor in CS. Like, when you're stepping into a battle, and you know that you're going to destroy the player that's on the other end, that basically puts you in such a good position to actually win that battle as well. Confidence is like so key, because when you think you're going to hit a shot, you have a 90% chance of actually hitting the shot. So I really like the confidence going up there for the Asterion boys. And that is also the land play factoring in there. You can boost each other's morale there. You can hype each other up. That's really what the Asterion boys are doing. And especially Kinzo is actually one of the players who does that a lot. You can hear screaming, shouting when they pick up a good round, and that is a really good for your team morale. Right now, the advantage, also for the Asterion boys. 5-on-4 situation. Right now, all Asterion need to do is just hold these sites and play it safe. Do not overpeak. They do not need to go overly aggressive. That is exactly what they are not doing. They're sitting back, they're playing it safe. It is Luis Ravo who actually drops here to the AK of Maul. That is now the B site for the Lowland Lions boys. Let's see if they can play a better off the plan. We're not Crucial with another frag there. Onto Slain with that AWP. He's been proven to be so dominant with that gun. Time and time again. And right now, Monu will get the AK frag there onto Amos. 2-on-4 situation right now. Fasher and Kinzo have it all to do. And are they going to go for this, Rick, or are they going to opt for the save? Well, Monu will take down Kinzo with a brilliant headshot. Fasher replies, though, onto Monu, but this is now a very bad round for Asterion, and especially when that happens. Aaron just comes around the corner. He's going to deny Fasher to save that gun, and that is a big deal. And that is going to Lions picking up their fifth round, and that is actually the confidence that they maybe built up from that super solid eco round. That is basically in shambles right now, because they now got destroyed.
Well, yeah, I mean, we talked about confidence, but, like, Lowland Lions, they are so mythological, and once they do commit suicide, it's such an aggression being shown from Lowland Lions, and it's hard to stop for Asterion. Looks like a bit of aggression again there, but Amos does find himself the frag of the Crucial, and he should not be getting away with that one. Kai's King, though, gonna reply quickly, so clearly getting the better over Amos, and Amos not really expecting Kai's King to be there already. Fasher is going to look around to take out Kai's King, but will get traded in by Monu. So this is very important for Lil Alliance. They are getting these trade frags in. However, it's still 3-3, and it doesn't look like that Lil Alliance have everything they want to have to play with at this current moment in time, if you look at them.
Yeah, that is actually a good point. Right now, it is. They just need to play, like you said, they're so methodical, and that is actually the reason why they can actually still win these rounds. Looks like the push is now on. It is Kinzu who's going to drop first. Loser Raver is going to miss the point blank shot. Moto will take him down instantly. And now it's all on Slay. And he's in a 1v3. He's going to miss the initial shot. He's going to miss the second shot onto Moto as well. He's being pushed right now. Moto will take him down with the Glock. That is adding insult to injury there, Rick. And Moto actually picking up three frags there in that, well, what shall we call it? That execute towards
it? Yeah, that entry. I mean, it's either very good play from Moto or very poor play from Mysterion.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't want to bash on them, but you should at least get a return.
Yeah, exactly.
My God, do something. But it's hard. It's easy to say as it does. Oh, wow. Lewis Raybo coming up with the default pistol, taking out Crucial, and it's really funny how you can see Asterion picking up kills with the default pistols against the fully equipped Lola Alliance. It's absolutely insane. But Lewis Raybo and Slain are both down and out. And it looks like the bomb has been planted on that B side. And again, Asterion do seem to be locked out of that side. As Lola Alliance are going to be setting up for a solo defense here. Moni's going to shut down Fasher, picking up that SMG. For a little bit more cash, knowing that Asterion is going to be down in economy, which is a good choice. And now it's just left up to Moe's and Kinzo. Kai's King is going to take out Kinzo, and that's going to be down to Moe's. He's not going to be doing much. Perhaps pick up his gun, but he's going to be denied by Aeron. So 7-5, Lola Alliance now in the lead by two rounds. It is 7-5. You do commence with the 13th round.
Yeah, and right now, Steron have a buy, but because it's CT economy, you can see that the buy is not, they don't have all that much to work with. And right now, Golden Giants are, they're playing so methodical right now. And let's see if Kai's King can do more entry work than he did before. He's on a very aggressive position. Toss out a nade there. Gonna connect with any of the CTs there though. And it's just a slow paced round once more from the Golden Giants. They're just gonna set up, they're gonna play it safe. Amos will actually land the first shot there onto Crucial. Moto will reply onto Amos, and Kai's King also aggressively on the mid will pick up two. Kinzo and Slain down and out of the equation. Now a 2-on-4 situation. Moto continues his spree as well onto Fasher. Now it's all on Lewis Ravo. And just as we said, they're playing a more slow and passive round. They just go ham. And they destroy us there, and Mole will mop up the remaining frag there. And Lewis Raybo will not have a chance of clutching that round. And that is 8-5 right now, Rick, and the Long Lions really showing their power and dominance there.
Well, are Asterion going to be able to pull out something out of the magical hat? And, well, it is an 8-5 again. It looks to be like a mimic of the Dust 2 game. If Asterion don't do something radical right now, it's... I'm afraid it's going to be a downhill struggle from this point on. As Modu is going to find himself the first one onto Lewis Raybo. Kai's King going to come from that mid approach, taking out Fasher. Still one more player out there in quad has been spotted by Kai's King himself. Modu though will take him out, and was Kinzo. And Amos so far the only man to reply with a nice little one pop. And Slain's going to get shut down as well by Kai's King. It's going to be Amos. In a 1-on-4, he's gonna get completely annihilated by Mole, and that's gonna be a 9-5 scoreline. And it's Asterion in a very difficult situation here. If they don't pick up this round, it's again trouble for them.
Yeah, picking up only 5 rounds on CT would be horrendous. So they really need to 6 rounds, because when they pick up the pistol, then they can actually even it up. Having that said, CT side on cash is just favorite. Like. Just, I don't know how good the T side of Asterion is and if they can rely on it, but let's hope they can. And right now, again, the standard setup we've seen from the Golden Giants more often. Kai's King again gonna be the danger man. This Raver this time will pick up that first frag. Kinzo's gonna get tagged. Oh, Fasher will peek out, will get taken down from Kai's King. Kai's King gets a fully flashed kill there onto Kinzo. That is insanity coming out of Kai's King once more. We've seen him do such great stuff. Slain in the meantime though is having the time of his life as well. He's picking up 2 op frags. Crucial as well now down. Looks like Kai's King will now be joining his teammate for a push. Slain will continue his spree. Amos will take down Aeron there in the end. But what a round there from Slain to get his team back in the round. Slain showing his dominance and his worth actually with that AWP.
Yeah, Celine, in that round, that's such a crucial crucial role there. I mean, Lilith Lines, it was clear that A approach did not work, and they were going to rotate towards that B side. Crucial was actually already in the side. He used that B smoke to his advantage to kind of sneak around it, but that was shut down by Celine. So that really was Celine stepping up his game and stepping up when it matters, because if they lost that round again, it's a 96 scoreline. It's still very possible. And then again, Dust2, their attack wasn't great. Yeah. We gotta point it out.
You gotta point it out there.
Now right Cash, now. Maybe they're gonna be feeling a little bit more confident, but Crucial now picking up two kills. Will get dropped though by Slain. And Asterial now approaching that side. It is Lone Alliance gonna go for the retake here. With this bomb hand being planted, Lewis Rave's gonna shut down Modu, and Slain will shut down Mole from the back. Brilliant play, and nice and patient from the Asterion guys here. And two more players on the Lone Alliance left alive, not for long, as Lewis Rave will take out their Kai's King. It's all left up to Aeron, who was on that bomb side. And Aeron picks himself with another frag of the Mose, but Slain give his position away, and Aeron gets it! And he's got himself a defuser as well. He's gonna defuse that bomb and will do it in a nick of time. Wow, Lone Alliance can absolutely clutch Aeron. That is just what the deuce just happened there? I mean, you have this Molly on the bomb side as well, but you'd say maybe Slain could have just fallen back, but he instead kind of...
He was stuck on the box, Rick. He was stuck on the box before, and he tried to throw out a flashbang, which basically didn't blind him. And then the defuse came in, and that is like, when we spoke about motivation boosters, this is something that's going to kill your motivation. Like, you're going to be sitting there like, yeah, that sucks.
I mean, I remember that Ninja defuse on Cash from Ketchup, one versus five.
Yeah, exactly.
And that just absolutely destroyed the other team. But yeah, it is now not so good stuff here for us.
Not so good stuff is putting it mildly there. As Lewis Ravel will give us some of the good stuff with that Deagle. We'll take down Kai's King. That is like we spoke of before, like, is it worth to buy Deagle when you can land shots like that? It basically means one click and your opponent is out of the round. So when you have good aim, then you're gonna have a lot of fun with that Deagle. But that being said, like I said before as well, it has a lot of RNG, so
yeah, it's a cheaper version of the glass cannon.
It's the mini. Yep, it's the mini version of the AWP. Well, as of right now, not really too much going on. Bomb is down though. See where that bomb is. Oh, it's actually in the face of Crucial. Well, as of right now, nothing really going on. Like I said, just a very slow and passive play. Right now, that passive play is not paying off. As Mole, Crucial, and Aeron combined will mop up the remaining Asterion players who were on full eco, of course. This is the round that is going to be crucial right now. Asterion, they need to pick up this one to stay in the game.
Yeah, I mean, can they do it? I mean, Lone Alliance on their Dust2, of course, they've shown a very solid defense. They're very dynamic in their play as well. They are able to rotate as soon as Asterion make a move. So maybe Asterion just need to kind of try and pull Lone Alliance into a full execute and to rotate towards that other bomb side. But it's like, Asterion gonna make it a bit of a slow approach. Crucial is gonna get shut down by the AK work of Kinzo. So that's a very solid player taking out that AWP early on. However, it is still a nitty gritty situation here for Lone Alliance. As Asterion is still between a rock and a hard place.
And right now, the position that Aeron is in, It's actually a common position nowadays. It's actually part of the new meta. To be fair, it is a hard position for him to play with that gun, and especially when his team is now on the back foot. It's 5-on-3 situation right now. Slain just took down Mole, and right now that is going to split up the defenses here for the Lions, and that is basically going to allow Asterion to just pick a side and do a good execute on it. Right now, it is Monu who's going to get dropped here by Slain. Gonna be the man over towards B. That means two players towards B. Oh, and look at this. Can't call this out too loudly yet, but It is Aaron actually landing a shot there onto Swain. Kinzo will reply onto Aaron right now, and it is a 1-on-4 situation. Kai'Sa King now is in a world of trouble. Kai'Sa King will get dropped, but I like how they sold that fake, because initially they thought it was going to be a B execute, like a B strat, a B plan, because Kinzo and Swain were actually over towards that B side, but the bomb was in reality going down towards A, which was a really a It was one of the smaller fakes, but still, it was a good fake here from Mysterion.
It was very clever from Mysterion, indeed. I mean, that's what you need to do against Little Alliance, trying to put them out of their comfort zone and not allowing them to dictate this map like they've done before. I mean, Little Alliance, they're such a team that once you can break them, then it should be easy. But that being said, Crucial here finding himself the one pop onto Slayin. And that's gonna put the Alliance in a bit of a sweeter spot. However, still some work to do here. And looks like Lures Ray was gonna even up the odds once more as Maul goes down to his AK. Fasher here at Twin Peaks. Moz though will find one on two. Kai'Sa King is now all very difficult here for Little Alliance with only three players left up alive for LLL. A lot more aggression being shown from Mysterion. They're going to try and flush out these defending players as Moz will find himself on yet another frag onto Moz. And oh wow, beautiful AK work there from Moz. Such a stellar performance here, dropping Aerol. Now all left with the Crucial with the deal to hand. Gonna have to go for the ace, but it's not gonna matter. Kinzo will already shut him down. And 11-8, that's a very nice approach here from Mysterion. And a slow, passive approach, which is really needed in that pistol round.
Yeah, and like right now, there's actually two things going in favor for Mysterion. Their pressure, I mean their confidence is now building. Also, their economy is building. So they have the confidence and the guns now to work with. Let's see if they can keep up this spree. I like how they actually learned from the mistakes. They took that anti-eco actually super passively, because they knew that in previous rounds, it's basically... They basically denied themselves out of rounds by walking in the stacks, and that is actually what they didn't do this time. So it's really good to see Mysterion actually learn from their mistakes and basically on anti-ecos. They now take a different approach to the game, which is a really good thing. As of right now, still super passive play, not really much going on, and that is exactly what I mean with the new way Mysterion are playing. They're not taking any chances. They don't want to walk into a pistol stack and get destroyed. Right now, no one but the Little Alliance players towards me. Fasher will pick up that first frag there onto Mole. That is a good kill. That allows them entry now on towards that site. Let's see if Fasher can continue the spree. Yes, he can. He will pick up three. That is a great stuff. Kinzo will follow up in the shoes of his teammate. Fasher will pick up four. Fasher is leading the charge here right now on this particular round. And that is maybe going to boost the morale up once more after losing an awkward pistol round, to say the least, Rick.
Yeah, I mean, Mysterion having an... I mean, a solid performance on that round, obviously. Little Alliance just having those four pistols. And now, 11-9. Mysterion coming in a bit closer to the Little Alliance score line. And let's see how they will approach it this time. Because the Little Alliance do remember, they have pretty much eco two rounds in a row. And I'm sure Mysterion are going to be expecting something with the Little Alliance to happen. So, bit of a slow approach here, and both teams actually, you know, kind of setting themselves up for a bit of a relaxed approach, you know, a bit of a dynamic approach. If there is anything gonna happen, then they will be able to rotate to either of the sites. And so far, it seems to be all quiet on the Western Front. So, Little Alliance still digging into the trenches. Mysterion for those first bloods. Could see Crucial here going for a bit of a cheeky peek, but kind of matter, he decided to back off just a little bit.
Enzo was actually smoked out of that position before, but it looks now like the push is going to be on. At least it seems so. And his Mortals coming out here. Oh, Crucial will land that first shot. Aaron will land the second. Amos will reply on the Aaron, though. The Crucial again with a shot. Loose Reaper, we're playing back and forth frags here. And now the push towards A is on. Can they hold on to this this lead and this bomb site that they have right now? It is going to be a hell of a task, to say the least, here for Aaron, but they desperately need this round. Slim will pick up the first. Kite King will get the instant revenge frag there. And now it's Ravo in a 1v2. We've seen him clutch these rounds. Land the first shot, will land it eventually. Does get tagged up from the back, doesn't reply fast enough. And that is Mole actually picking up the round there for Golden Lions. A really scrappy round. Only one player of the CTs surviving. Mole has enough time to pick up this defuse, maybe salvage an AWP as well. That was Crucial's AWP, actually. And that is the 12th round, and this is now, right now, even though Asterion have the economy, this is one of the most important rounds right now, because they need to keep close to Golden Lions if they want to like pick up this map and basically proceed in this best of three.
Yeah, they certainly can't have Lola Lions pull away like they have done. And well, you know, in that round as well, I think Mole pretty much had that round as well in the back, because Lewis Raver had no idea was out there, so it was pretty fair to say that Lola Lions actually came around quite confident, despite having lost four of their players. But either way, Asterion now again measuring a bit of defense, maybe taking out the Lola Lions players, perhaps bomb around just a little bit, and kind of wondering they're up to more here. Does find himself the first one. That's gonna be one of your players down on B. It's gonna be Kinzo down and out. Kinzo being shut down early, it's gonna cause a bit of trouble. So you can see definitely now Asterion seem to be struggling a little bit, and Lone Lion's using already a fair amount of utility, as well as Asterion still. Back-to-back fight. Mid. Asterion still put his entries. Loser, we can definitely see he's working on it. We can't find anyone. Slim, meanwhile, spraying a couple of shots through his smoke. Loser Raver does find himself an entry onto Crucial. And that A push is gonna commence. So Fasher with that bomb. Gonna go ahead and stick it. Aaron, though, in the flank, shuts down Amos, and could this be another retake for Lone Lion? Certainly looks like it, as Monush is going to shut down Fasher. It's all down to Slay and Lewis Raybo to prevent that defuse from happening. They just need to stop that defuse from happening, and it's easier said than done, as Mole will take out Lewis Raybo, but Slay did take out Mole, but Aaron will shut down Slay, and that's going to be the defuse coming in with plenty of time to spare as well. Still three more players up from Lone Lion. It's a very solid defense from them. It's going to be 13-9. And a very difficult situation here for Asterion. I mean, that's sad. Still, their economy is doing quite okay.
Yeah, their economy is doing okay for now. Like, to be fair, one of the strong factors when you're playing on T side as well is that you get that lost bonus after a few rounds starts increasing. Oh, it's Ravel. That is just painful. He just takes down Kaiskin instantly towards the middle there. Brilliant shot from his Raybo. And he is showing us that he can not only just op, he can also play very well with that AK. Kinzo in the meantime as well onto Monu. That was over towards the B side this time. That's going to force a rotation. And we have to wait and see if that rotation is correct. As of right now, it's going to be a slower part here in the round. Asterion know they have the advantage. They don't need to move hastily. They can just calm down, slow it down. That's what they're doing on the lines right now. Very much on the back foot. Is Mole going to be able to do some damage here? He's going to land the first. Can he land the second? Yes, he can. Headshot there onto Fasher. What a brilliant defense here so far from Mole. Spots the second. Now only has a USPS to work with. And this is, he's in such a pickle right now. Actually hits the shot there onto Slain. Right now, 3-on-2 situation, and the retake is on for the Golden Lions. Molotovs are going to go out towards the side. That is going to force some position switches here. Crucial will land the shot there onto Kinzo. What a shot. Aaron will burn Slain alive, and it is now a 1-on-2 situation for Amos. Can he pull this off to keep his team in the round? He will land the first headshot there onto Crucial. It's now a 1-on-1. Aaron, he is over towards that site right now. It is this is it all to play for, and is he gonna stick it? Yes, Aaron will get that ninja defuse there. Amos not opting to go for that aggression. He couldn't possibly know that he was sticking that defuse, but Aaron did it. And Rick, pros don't fake.
Well, that certainly proved the point there, right? 14-9, and I think this is the point where Styrion is gonna scratch the back of their head and ask themselves what just happened.
Again. You know, we've seen this in the pistol. We've seen this now. Them losing a round. You should not lose. Especially 1v1 like that. I mean, it's going to be rough times for them. They have a bye, though. That's good.
Yeah, well, certainly that has been known now by Lower Lines as those AK shots were being fired away. Nothing connecting so far. And again, Styrion looking to measure the defense of Lola Lines, but Arrow just comes around the corner, takes out two players, make that three as Amos goes down. Arrow wants to close out this game in style by the looks of it. It is a 2-on-5 now. Slain does find himself the return onto Arrow. And now Slain and Kenzo, they're gonna have to deliver. They want to keep Asterion into this game, into the semi-final of the Benelux Championship. While Flash comes out, and there's another player for Little Highlights. Kaisken goes down. It's all left to Kinzo now. Slain, they take out Kaisken. Kinzo now going to shut down Crucial. It's down to a 1-on-2. Kinzo, can he deliver against two players? Kinzo finds himself the frag on the Monu, but more will shove it out from the backside. Brilliant news from the buddy system there from Lola Lions. 15-9 is going to be the match point. In fact, 6 max points for Lola Lions. And it was so brilliant play from Meryl. And then really ballsy as well, like just coming out from main and taking out two players and then returning as well for that third frag.
Like, you can just see the confidence on Aaron there, especially he's playing so well on this map, Rick. He's 28-14. He's on the 2k kill death ratio right now. He's doing damage, and when you're doing damage like that, you're gonna go for plays like that, and it's gonna work out. Like we said before, this game is for such a big part about confidence, and Aaron's showing us exactly why that is. Right now, the push is on for Asterion. Can they hold on? Can they claw on through a slither of hope here? Kinzo and Fasher are surely gonna try to keep their team into this game. And the bomb is already down. She's one of the faster rounds here. Amos will get an 8 frag of the Mono. 2-on-5 situation right now. Not sure if Lowenstein should go for this. I mean, why would they? Right now, Crucial is going to reply there with the UMP onto Slain. It is now a 2-on-4 situation. It's still a very rough position for the Lions to be in. And the bomb is taken away. There's almost no more time. And will they try and go for it? Maul will get one. Israfel will instantly reply though with that auto shotgun. Gonna swap that out for that M4. And the Crucial now doing some more damage. Picking up one more, but still we will fall to the bomb explosion. And right now, that's Asterion. They're hanging on for dear life, Rick.
That's certainly true. But still, Lone and Lions now not having the best of times in their wallets. But yeah, Asterion still having built up that slight economy from the loser bonus, which is not, you know, the best things, of course. But Asterion, they can pretty much go out every single round because they have to. They have to buy everything they got. And Asterion really should now be setting up for a bit of a split approach, perhaps, and going for the speaks knowingly that Lola Lions will probably not have the best of buys, or...
Well, a very crappy buy, so to say. Or not a buy at all, whatever you want to call it. Right now, the aggression is coming out of Asterion. They need to grab hold of at least one position here on the map, and that's exactly what they're doing. Fasher's going to be leading that charge, going to clear all the corners. Is he going to clear right corners though. He will take down more Percy. He will take down Monu as he comes around that corner. Of course, these are eco frags. Makes it a little bit more easy for him. But as I said that, Aaron will take his head clean off with the QSP. Aaron playing so well, showing us exactly how much he can do, even whilst being on a USP. Right now, Asterion are going on the aggression. I'm not sure why they're going so aggressive. They're only allowing for Crucial now to get some more kills. Swain will take him down in the end there, but still, they lose two players, Asterion, and it's not the end of the world. But when you know you're playing against full eco, I'm not sure if you should go for the full aggression there.
Yeah, it's a little bit scary that Asterion then maybe sometimes play a little bit reckless. And having Aaron just coming around just in their face with a USPS Hatchel as well is crucial. I mean, it shows that Lil and Lions definitely are able, well unable to close out this game. But again, that having said, Asterion should probably be able to pick up this round unless something relentlessly will go wrong. But there we go, Moe's gonna finish off two players. Slain will follow up quickly as well. Aaron though does reply. It's again Aaron picking up a kill with the default pistol. But Slain will reply with one frag of his own. And it's gonna be an AK shot to the head. And it's gonna be more remaining alone in the wild. Will get taken out by Fasher as well. So 15-12.
And right now, this is the round. This is the round where Asterion need to keep this up. If they, basically, if they win this one, they're gonna put them on another eco, and that is so. Let us see if Asterion can hold on, like we said, for dear life here. So right now, again, more passive setup. They're not gonna go for the early aggression. They know how much. Is riding on this round right now. Very, very passive play, and I like this from Asterion. They're actually gonna go, they're gonna go slow at it.
I think also in this moment in time, both teams should feel the pressure, because if Lone Alliance lose this round, they're gonna be in trouble economy-wise yet again. And I don't think Lone Alliance want to bring this to a third map or to an overtime at all. And we might speak too early, but you know, Asterion, they're well capable in turning this one around. And will they be able to show us this as the aggression comes in? But the flashbang, Aaron's gonna take a one. Kai's King with a double kill. Kai's King has been dropped though, but it's all falling apart and they're gonna make me jinx.
And there we go. Just as we said it, just as we said that this is the more important round. Look at how clean Lowland Lions pick it up as well.
Yeah.
And that is the first map right now for the Lowland Lions.
Yeah, a great map here. Yeah, the first win, the first semi-final goes to Lowland Lions. They advance over Asterion. Very much a better game here from Asterion. It almost felt they had the possibility of a comeback there. If they won the last round, the economy of them would be so strong and they might push it to a draw there to 15-15 and we could go to overtime.
Yeah, well, it was certainly very close, but Lowland Lions with those counter flashes actually just stopped that A push like completely, and I mean, I was hoping for it that Asterion would do it, but unfortunately, it didn't happen. And Lowland Lions now closing it out with 2-0s in terms of map.
Yeah, we're always looking for those tense moments, but Lowland Lions did it. They did it in the first map, they did it in the second map with a great individual skill, with great team tactics. But with that fake, I almost had the feeling that Asterion could come back, but it's well deserved here by Lowland Lions, and especially with players like Kai's King and Crucial, because they're on the stage here with Daniel, and they have, well, they have something to say. All right, so we're just waiting a little bit on that one. So
yeah, Kai's King, congratulations.
Thanks, man.
How did it go? Dust2, first map, talk us through it.
Dust2 went pretty good for us. It's a kind of open map. We didn't prac for 2 weeks because our in-game leader was on holiday. So we just did a bit of pick and play, and it worked out really well. And then Cash, whew, it was hard. They practiced it, I guess, and it's just hard to play it as a kind of a mix. But we got it, so I'm happy.
I saw some hugging going on between you two teams at the end. Are there friends of yours on the enemy team?
Yeah, of course.
So that's because the Dutch scene is kind of small still?
Really small.
Too small.
Let me ask about the MVP of this game, because I thought Crucial was at the right place, the right time, all the time.
He was playing good, but I think on Cash, Aaron played better than Crucial. He was just insane on A. So Crucial, Aaron for me.
Okay, now you guys have secured this final spot. It's going to be against Acer Gaming or Venko Gaming. What do you think?
Close game. But my money is on Venko.
And if you face them in the finals, what do you think? Who will? Well, of course, I think you're going to take home the victory. But what will be your strong points in this final?
I think we're just all five really good players, and we can just play any map, any time. So we're ready.
Okay, and the fact that you haven't practiced a whole lot, is that going to matter?
We practice individually, so it's going to be okay.
Okay, last question. Do you think your performance is more a question of individual good players, or is the team spirit really contributing to your wins?
At the moment, I think we're just better individual. As I said, we didn't prac, but we need to focus a little bit more on the team play indeed, but it's working out.
Okay, good luck in the finals.
Thanks, man.
Thanks a lot. Okay, so we're going to head over to a little break, and then we're going to see the second semifinal between Venko Gaming and Acer Gaming. Be right back.